The project Infrastructure Assets Management for the Water Supply and Sanitation Sector in South East Europe is funded by the Ministry of Economic Development and Cooperation of Germany and the Government of Switzerland, and implemented by the German Association for International Cooperation, GIZ, the Open Regional Fund for SCEE, Modernization of Municipal Services, and the Network of Associations of Local Authorities of South East Europe. Infrastructure Assets Management of Public Enterprises is an integrated approach in the monitoring, operations, maintenance, and upgrading in a cost-efficient manner while maintaining the required level of services. The lack of a suitable management system of the existing infrastructure in the water sector has brought about the need to develop a special tool that will be used in business planning, as well as in identifying priorities for investments and interventions, as well as to make better decisions. 40 mayors, directors and employees in water utility companies held a kick-off meeting on the 14th of October in Belgrade, Serbia, where they discussed the necessity to implement such a model.
Проектот ќе се имплементира во 6 земји на Југоисточна Европа, меѓу кои се Македонија, Србија, Црна Гора, Босна и Херцеговина, Албанија и Косово. Ќе се одберат 7 пилот општини и комунални предпријатија, каде што ќе се тестира овој модел и ќе се видат првичните резултати. Идејата е, од кога ќе се добие успешен тестиран модел, истиот да се прошири и во поголем број на јавни предпријатија и општини во регионот.
The new tool will enable us to evaluate the current situation in the company, its potential for taking new loans or credits intended for certain infrastructure investments, as well as to identify new infrastructure priorities.
Овој модел треба да понуди еден документ со кој што ќе можат јавните предпријатија и општините понатаму да аплицираат до меѓународните финансиски институции за поддршка на капиталните инфраструктурни проекти во областта на водоснабдувањето на локално ниво.
According to consultant Petros Olavopoulos, this is not simply a model, but a process that brings together the technical and financial staff of water utility companies in elaborating the priorities and why a certain investment is necessary in front of the decision makers in a company and the municipality.
It's the first time we developed this model, but it's built on the experience we have over the last 15 years implementing asset management. So we understand the problems the decision makers have, and we understand how everything has to come together. So on the one hand, asset management, on the other hand, investment plans, and all these have to be translated to funding requirements. So this is a very critical exercise for the utilities and for the decision makers to be able to compile these programs and decide on how they're going to finance and how they're going to enable and do proper asset management in the municipalities.
Utility companies manage the assets of the local authorities, the municipalities, and therefore their close cooperation is vital. This model allows the two entities to meet at the same table and discuss the pre-developed scenarios for short-term, medium-term and long-term investments.
Проблемот не е едноставен за решавање, иако најголем дел од проблемите ние веќе ги имаме детектирано, меѓутоа нашите комунални предпријатија се ставени да во една позиција да треба да менаџираат со водните ресурси, меѓутоа да не се водат од економската логика, туку пред се да го согледаат социјалниот аспект, пред се се мисли при одредување на цените за услугите, и кога имаме еден таков аспект на одредување на цените, веќе станува комплицирано да се изменаджираат сите оние потреби кои што следуваат при понатамошни инвестиции.
Apart from Probištip, other pilot municipalities where the business planning model will be developed are Korča, Subotica, Nikšić, Bijeljina, Banja Luka and Velika Kladuša.
Ja moram se zahvaliti svima onima koji su izabrali, odnosno odabrali i dali mogućnost da vodovod Velike Kladuše uđe u pilot projekat upravljanje imovinom vodovodnih poduzeća, odnosno i grada, odnosno općine Velika Kladuša, i vjerujem da će nam to u mnogome pomoći da saznamo i više povedemo računa o imovini samog komunalnog poduzeća, odnosno usluzi, kvalitetnoj usluzi građana za koje smo upravo i namijenjeni i formirani.
The most important reason why utility companies should implement the assets management is the concern regarding the aging of physical assets of which they are in charge. There is a significant need to replace or upgrade such outdated assets because they impede the delivery of the required level of services. Usually, public companies lack funds to renovate or to replace their entire worn-out assets. Therefore, they need a strategic and integrated approach.
Treba da doprinese upravo preciznijem planiranju, odnosno pravom planiranju u smislu gdje treba da ulažemo sredstva u rekonstrukciju vodovodne mreže, zamjenu određenih dijelova mreže i samim tim, kada se završi taj dio, trebalo bi da imamo efekte, finansijske efekte, znači da su smanjene curenja, da je povećan kvalitet u smislu isporuke vode našim potrošačima.
Da će dovesti do sigurno stvaranje uslova o samoodrživosti i firme, znači da će se na planski način trošiti sva sredstva koja se angažuju u jednom javnom preduzeću za sve oblasti funkcionisanja.
Their entire approach is fully transparent. The investment plan will be evaluated, thus allowing us to know in advance what the savings will be and why such a plan should be implemented. The monitoring will be conducted simultaneously with the implementation, thus enabling the citizens to know exactly where and how their money is spent.
Ja mislim da do sada nismo mogli unapred predvidjeti koje će razvojne poduhvate će preuzeti grad. Iz tog aspekta ja mislim da je veoma dobro da potrošači budu na vrijeme informisani i što se razvoja i što se održavanja sistema tiče.
This will be part of our job during all the way, so we will keep them informed as we do always with issues that has to do with the cost that they have to pay.
The working group on the infrastructure assets management held its fifth working meeting where the business planning tool intended to support the decision makers was presented. Working group's members actively discussed and presented their proposals and suggestions in order to reach a final product that suits the actual situation in the region. The concept of e-training related to the infrastructure assets management was presented at the same meeting. The members evaluated it as a very interesting and useful manner in which to raise the awareness of infrastructure assets management. Finally, the members discussed the possibilities of prolonging the activities related to the infrastructure assets management in both programs, GIZ Open Regional Fund for SEE and the Danube Water Program by the World Bank. All participants concluded that it would be very significant for the support of the water utility companies in the SEE region to prolong activities until December 2018, and it would also contribute to the improvement of services delivered to the citizens by those companies in the said municipalities.